you know, punish myself by feeling like a failure. Hi, BookTube. I'm here with my May TBR, and I'm so excited because it's a game, and I, like, been obsessively watching TBR games. I think I've hit, like, 90% of the people who have TBR games, I've watched their videos. And the other 10% is just because, you know, I'd get to the end of a list and I'd fall asleep and I couldn't find my way back to the end of the list. So yeah, I've been binging TBR games and just decided to make my own. And I decided to make it Supernatural themed. You can't see it, but I am wearing my Dean shirt right now. I'm gonna explain the game just very quickly at first, and then I'll cut to gameplay and then back to the books. Yeah, okay. So, check my handy dandy list of rules. So I begin each round by picking a villain, and that's gonna be the overarching challenge for picking my books. So for example, some of my villains include Soulless Sam, which means I can only choose library books. Chuck, which means all books must be nonfiction. What's another one here? Lucifer, each book must be a different color. Crowley, no authors from the US or Canada. So that will dictate my then overall TBR. Just a word, there are going to be 3 books each month that are exempt from this, and that's because they're books for the Great Courses curriculum thing that I have, and they were picked out, you know, at the beginning of the year. So those are already set in place and may not fit the overarching theme, but every subsequent book after that will. Okay, I just rolled a 6-sided dice and move along on my board spaces. And the color I land on my board determines what card I pick a pile from. So I have blue, red, and purple. So if I land on a blue square, I have to pick up a blue card. Which looks like this. They're just laminated cardstock, and then they have a prop and a prompt on the other side. And these are basically methods of picking my book. So for example, an angel blade, if I land on that, it means I have to pick a random number generator of my physical books. If I get John's journal, I have to ask a friend to pick a book for me. If I get the Malik box, which is, if you remember, when Dean gets possessed by Michael, he creates a Malik box to contain him. I have to choose a hardcover book, you know, those kind of things, different methods. If I choose a red card, again, the same thing, just laminated cardstock with a character on it. This one's Bobby. Those are linked to my reading goals. So for example, if I pick Cass, I have to choose from a list of books from Read the World. If I get Mary, it's a book I have to review. If I get, let's see, who else is here? If I get Jody, it has to be the first unread book on a shelf. and, you know, Sam has to come from my most anticipated ebooks. And then the purple cards are different creatures, and those are library prompts, so the purple laminated card, and then it'll have one of the creatures on it. This one's the teddy that came to life. I was running out of creatures at that point, you can tell. And so these are just books that I have to get from the library. So for example, if I get a vampire, it has to be a classic. If I get a ghost, it has to be the first book on a shelf. If I get a shapeshifter, it has to be a book from multiple perspectives. If I get, if I get a djinn, it has to be on my most want to read list, so I have a list of books that I want from the library on my computer. So those kind of things are what the cards mean. If I land on a card that has, if I land on a square that has that star on it, then I'm exempt from the overarching challenge in getting that book. I might not always choose to do that, but that is an option. I'm going to pick 10 to 12 books each month, depending on how ambitious I feel, because I do have those additional 3 books that aren't included in the prompts. And lastly, there are no punishments in this game. These are just, I just like having a large selection in the, in the month to choose from, and this is how I'm going to be selecting them. If I don't finish them, you know, I'll just, you know, punish myself by feeling like a failure. Yeah, that's it. Let's cut to gameplay. So, this is the game board set up. I got these, I don't know what the official thing is, vinyl sugar creatures. So there we have Dean as my playing piece because he's my favorite character. But we have Sam and Cass watching us over. Let's turn him to face the camera. Okay, so we're gonna start, and I'm going to pick up a villain card to start the game. And our villain is Death Billy, and that means that none of the authors can be white. So, because she's like the only, one of the only people of color on the show. So yeah, we'll set that off to the side there as a reminder. And let's get into it. Okay. So we start off with a one. And that's a red card. And that is Bobby, a book I've started but haven't finished. Okay, so I got Bobby, and that is a book I've started but haven't finished yet. I don't know if that will focus. I took autofocus off because it makes a weird noise, but there's Bobby. And for that one, I decided to go with this black leopard, red wolf. Oh, I still have the bookmark in there. That is so handy because I do remember the story very well. So I'm on page 190. So this is like 90% of my DNFs, or me just like not wanting to DNF the book, like to just get it off my shelf, but just, it's not right at that moment. So I just set it aside and we'll pick it up at a later date, hopefully. That's why that was one of my goal cards. So Black Leopard, Red Wolf, continuing this, it's by Marlon James. It's a fantasy. We follow this guy named Tracker, and he, I don't really know how to describe it. It's really weird. And he makes friends with this leopard. Where'd shepherd come from? I don't know. Okay. And he makes friends with this leopard shapeshifter thing, I believe. And yes, it's off on an adventure. It's a really weird, interesting story. Six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Another red card. And this time we got Eileen, and we're gonna pick a disabled author. And that pick is Eileen. For a disabled author, Eileen is a deaf character on Supernatural. So yeah, for that, I'm going with an ebook, and I'm gonna read An In Kindness of Ghosts by River Solomon. And I read just a few months ago Sorrowland and thoroughly enjoyed that, so I decided to pick this one up. I can't entirely remember what this one is about, but it's by River Solomon, so I mean, I'm pretty sure with how much I loved Sorrowland that I'm gonna enjoy that one as well. Okay. A four. One, two, three, four is a blue card, so it's a prop. And Salt, it's gonna be the first book I see on Instagram. And let's be clear that if the first book I see is by a white author, then it has to be the first book I see that's not by a white author. So that's how those work. Even if it's like the first book on the shelf, it will have to be the first book that fits the villain card. So that was Salt, which is the first book I see on Instagram, and I'll insert some footage here of me looking on Instagram for a book. Carry on my wayward son, there'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest, don't you cry no more. Okay, so you see I landed on a series of books there, and it just kind of honed in on one that had an interesting title. I don't actually know what it's about. This is Territory of Light by Yuko Tsushima. So I will be reading that for the salt prompt. Okay. Oh, that's a one. So let's purple. And that's Angel, so a random number generator for fiction.
you can hear me. I'm sitting by a highway, but the river is behind me and it's a beautiful day. So I thought I'd just go through what I got from the library here. I brought my deck of cards here, and the purple ones are the library ones, so let's just pull those out. Do the random number generator for fiction, and that was shelf 5, so I just went from like A, like the very first A shelf in fiction, and counted 5 shelves, and it was the first bookcase in that shelf. That makes sense. And I got this, and this is a book I've wanted to read for a while, so this might even fit for 5-star prediction. The Pearl That Broke Its Shell by Nadia Hashimi. She's from Afghanistan. And this is about this practice in Afghanistan called Bacha Poch, which allows a young girl to present as a boy and be treated as a boy if they're like the only girl in their family, because like being a boy is very important to the family. So that's about a case of that. So that sounds really cool. I've had my eye on this book for a while.
3, 1, 2, 3, another creature card, and we got Teddy, and that will be the last book on the shelf.
The last book on a shelf, and my thing was with this, I was going around checking all the last books on the shelves, and they were all by white people, and it had to be, my challenge was a person of color. So I found it was the second last book on the shelf, and it looked really cool. So this is God of Mercy by Okizi Nwaka, and this is a fantasy, it seems. In the village of the Chulu, the people's worship of their gods and adherence to tradition has allowed them to evade the tyranny of the white ones, but the village is reckoning with changes, including a war between gods, signaled by Ijioma, a girl who can fly. And that sounds really cool. And that cover is good.
Okay. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Another red card. So this is number 5. We have Gabriel. We're gonna start a new series. And that was Gabriel, and he's the trickster. And the trick here is to start a new series. Wonderful, isn't that? That's just what I needed, was to start a new series. I put the card in there. And I decided to go with this, and it looks like a big book, but it's actually 3-in-1. So this is the Inheritance Trilogy by N.K. Jemisin, and the first book in here is The 100,000 Kingdoms. That was actually the first book I heard about by her, but I've read the Fifth Season Trilogy, don't remember the name of it, and thoroughly enjoyed that. So I'm looking forward to reading this one. Banshee, a 5-star prediction. Once I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse beyond this illusion, I was soaring ever higher. A 5-star prediction. I did have to look this one up in advance too, to see if they had it. And I've been wanting to read some Haruki Murakami. My brother just did a video about him. I'll link that down below. So I decided to pull up Killing Commentator. I'm never going to be able to pronounce that properly. And this is about a guy discovers a painting. There's bugs. Discovers a painting, and then he gets pulled into this mystery. I don't like knowing too much about my books before going in. But yeah, so there's this chunker by Haruki Murakami. Okay, again, 2, 1, 2. Oh, so this one's exempt. I probably won't exempt myself from this though. So that's the First Blade random page number generator. So I got the First Blade, which is the random page number generator. So I'm going to randomize a number between 1 and 8 or 1 and 9, and I'll have to times that by 100, and that will be the page length that I have to go for. It could be anywhere. If it lands on like a 5, it'll have to be between 500 and 599 pages. So for that, I got a 2, as you saw, and I picked up Family Life by Akhil Sharma, and I believe this one is 218 pages, 219 if you include the acknowledgements. So yeah, just there. Oh, I picked this up because Akhil Sharma is possessed of a narrative voice as hypnotic as those found in the pages of Dostoevsky. So, I mean, it's only 200 pages. Dostoevsky's known for his really long novels, but we'll see. I'm really excited to go to that. Oop, all the way over there, but it's a 2, 1, 2. We get Garth, and that's gonna be a reread. And that was Garth, and that's a reread, because Garth appears many times on Supernatural in different roles. And I think each time you reread, you see the book in a new light, right? So yeah, we got Garth. He's one of my favorite characters too, so it makes sense to reread a favorite book. And for that, I'm gonna reread The Truth About Stories by Thomas King. And this is a series of lectures he gave at Massey Hall about storytelling. And it's interesting because he ends every chapter with it's turtles all the way down. Or he begins it. I think he begins it with that. I just gotta make sure it's the beginning. Yeah, there's a story, you know, it's about the Earth and how it floats in space on the back of a turtle. It says, one time it was on Prince Rupert, I think, a young girl in the audience asked about the turtle and the Earth. If the Earth was on the back of a turtle, what was below the turtle? Another turtle, the storyteller told her. And below that, another turtle. And below that, another turtle. And, you know, it's turtles all the way down. See, that's not a John Green book. He stole that. That's all I'm gonna say. That'll be fun. Oh, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, hi, Cass. Gotta move ya. And that is Witch, a random letter generator for the author's last name.
For that one. Oh, this one is really cool. Okay. So I had to do a random letter generator for Witch, and I got the letter R. And initially I was thinking Samuel R. Delaney, but they didn't have any of his books. Like, I could always put hold and get them from the other libraries, but I like being able to find them on the shelves myself, going into the library. But I looked out and I found this cool book, which has cats all over it, called The Wildings by Nilanjana Roy. And she is from Delhi. Cool. And she has cats. So this is a book about cats. In the labyrinthine alleys and ruins of Nizamuddin, a neighborhood in Delhi, India, lives a small band of cats. And this is following the cats, and it's the first in a series, and as it's like, a book about cats for adults. It's not like a kid's book. It's for adults. Okay. It's getting windy.
Ooh, 1. A red exempt card. Baby, a most anticipated audiobook. So we will pull from the things. Those are prompts. This one is audiobooks. And we will pull until we get a person of color author. Archivist Wasp, unfortunately she's white. Deeper down. Circe, it's another white author. Oh boy. This is why I resist. She's Nigerian-British, so that will be the audiobook. And then I got the best character in the show, Baby. Yes, I'm counting Baby as a character. She has a name, therefore she is a character, not a prop. And for this I chose most anticipated audiobooks. And you'll see me, I picked that out during gameplay, and that is called This Is Why I Resist, and I don't have... Hey Google, who wrote This Is Why I Resist?
Shola Mos-Shogbamimu wrote This Is Why I Resist. Don't define my black identity.
I'm glad she pronounced that and not me. I'm pretty sure I would have had trouble with it. So yeah, that's that audiobook. It's about racism and why we should fight against racism. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We got A Deity, a book on religion.
So for the Deity card, I had to pick a book on religion, and the book that I initially wanted wasn't there. So I spent a good time browsing the shelves. They don't have a lot of books written about religion by people of color. I was looking specifically for something about Christianity, but oh well. So I got My Gita by Devdutt Pattanaik. Sure. And he basically goes through the Bhagavad Gita thematically. So it's written out not thematically, but he's going through it thematically, and I don't know anything about Hinduism. So I thought that's a place to start.
So one. Oh, I think we're at 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We're there. Okay. So we didn't have to do any more. That's the gameplay.
So, editing Courtney here, because I didn't film an outro, and I didn't talk about the three other books that I was going to read that aren't included in the gameplay. So, my course for this month is Changing Body Composition Through Diet and Exercise. something I'm really... I want to learn more about it, so that's why it's on the list anyways. And the nonfiction I'm going to be reading is called, it's called No Sweat, How the Simple Science of Motivation Can Bring You a Lifetime of Fitness by Michelle Seger. So this kind of appeals to me because I'm really interested in reading science nonfiction. So hopefully that will motivate me to read that. And the, fiction book I'm going to be reading is called King Leary. Yeah, King Leary. By Paul Quarrington, and I initially picked it up, like, bought it, because it was on a Canada Reads that I hadn't watched before I knew about Canada Reads. And I think it's about a retired hockey player. that's like the only sports book I have on my shelf. That I could think of. So that's on the list. And then I'll be doing the chapter of the Portable Seminary. And that I'll actually be doing April's because I didn't do it in April. Yeah. And I'll be reading that same book, the same additional supplement for that, and that is And God Said, How Translations Conceal the Bible's Original Meaning by Joel Hoffman. And that's talking about, you know, the problems with translations and the meaning of the text and that kind of stuff. So, yeah, that's my May TBR. I had so much fun making this game. It was very intensive. I didn't realize how intensive it would be, thinking of everything and getting everything together and designing a game board and all that kind of stuff. It was really cool. So let me know if you've read any of these books and the book that you're looking forward to reading the most in May yourself. Thank you for watching.